Hi friends, this is Dr. Krupa Savda, and our today's topic of discussion is criminal responsibilities of a mentally ill person. This is a very important topic by the perspective of forensic psychiatry as well as legal perspective. If you are new to this channel, consider subscribing and sharing, and if you want more video links, you can visit the description box. Section 22 of Bharatiya Nyay Samhita, or we can say Section 84 of Indian Penal Code, that is IPC, deals with the criminal responsibility of insane persons. So the person who are insane, who are having unsoundness of mind, Section 22 BNS and Section 84 IPC deals with that. It states that nothing is an offense which is done by a person who, at the time of doing it, because of unsoundness of mind, is incapable of knowing the nature of the act, or what he is doing is either wrong or contrary to law. यानी कि ऐसे person को जो offense करता है उसका offense जो है वो नहीं माना जाएगा अगर या तो वो unsound है, unsound minded है, या तो फिर incapable of knowing the nature of act, और जो वो कर रहा है वो लॉ के विरुद्ध है या तो फिर वो गलत है. यस, देयर इज माइनर डिफरेंस बिटवीन सेक्शन 84 आईपीसी और 22 बीएनएस एंड मैकनोटन्स रूल, राइट, विच इज द गाइडलाइन फॉलोड इन ब्रिटिश कोर्ट्स फॉर कंसीडरिंग द लायबिलिटी ऑफ अ मेंटली इल पर्सन हु कमिट्स अ क्राइम, राइट. सो देयर इज वेरी माइनर डिफरेंस. Now we'll see मैकनोटन्स रूल, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी मीन्स लायबिलिटी ऑफ अ पर्सन ऑफ for his acts or omissions, and the person is liable for punishment for any illegal act, right? If person is doing act which is illegal or jo usko nahi karna chahiye, to fir usko jo hai wo punishment ho sakti hai agar wo illegal act karta hai. The law presumes every individual to be sane or sound mind and responsible for his criminal act unless the contrary is proved. So, जब तक वो अनसाउंड प्रूव नहीं हो जाता तब तक वो हर एक क्रिमिनल एक्ट के लिए जो पर्सन है अगर वो सेन है, साउंड माइंडेड है, तो लॉ ऐसा प्रिज्यूम करता है कि वो क्रिमिनल है, राइट, एंड ही इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर क्रिमिनल एक्ट. ओके, द क्रिमिनल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ एन इनसेन गॉट पब्लिक अटेंशन इन 1843. सो सी, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस वीडियो. And if you want to continue this important section, you can, you want to see the full video because this is a very important story. Macnaughton, a 29-year-old Scotsman laboring under a delusion. So that particular person on which this act, that is, or this law, Macnaughton's rule is there, he was suffering from delusional ideas, right? Or laboring under a delusion. Should that Edward Drummond, the secretary to British Prime Minister Sir Robert Peel. So that particular person should dead, right? Okay, and that person was the secretary to the British Prime Minister Sir Robert Peel. Macnaughton was paranoid, schizophrenic, and had the delusion that Sir Robert Peel was conspiring against him, right? So this is very important that this particular person was unsound minded. He was paranoid, schizophrenic, and had a delusional thoughts. He had intended to kill Sir Robert Peel, but mistakenly killed Drummond, right? So यहाँ पे ऐसा कहा गया है कि उसको जो है वो रॉबर्ट पील को वो मारने वाला था, but उन्होंने ड्रमंड को मार दिया, right? The jury, after hearing medical evidence from 9 physicians, found Macnaughton not guilty by reason of unsoundness of mind. So this is very clear that the person was unsound, right? And 9 physicians, the jury, after hearing medical evidence from 9 physicians, they found that this particular person is not guilty because of reason of unsoundness of mind. Queen Victoria, Sir Robert Peel and other well-known people were outraged by the verdict. So by this verdict, the people got, they were outraged, right? Because they told that Macnaughton is not guilty. They invited 15 eminent judges to the House of Lords and were requested to respond to a series of questions on the criminal responsibility of the insane. So see, this is very important. As they were outraged by this given verdict, they invited 15 eminent judges to the House of Lords and requested to respond to a series of questions on criminal responsibility of the insane. The learned judges' answer were immortalized in history. So their answers become immortal, right? And have become known as McNaughton's rule or the legal test or right wrong test. This is very important. So now the rule states that to establish a defense on the ground of insanity, it must be proved that at the time of committing act, the party accused was laboring under such a defect of reason from the disease of mind as not to know the nature and quality of the act he was doing, or if he did know it, that he did not know he was doing what was wrong. So, यहाँ पे ऐसा कहा गया है कि जब कोई भी इंसान क्रिमिनल एक्ट करता है, राइट, तो अगर वो आइदर अनसाउंड है या तो डिफेक्टेड माइंडेड है या तो वो जो कर रहा है उसका नेचर एंड क्वालिटी, जो एक्ट कर रहा है वो उसको पता नहीं है, देन इट इज अ डिफेंस फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर पर्सन और ग्राउंड ऑफ इंसेनिटी, राइट, डिफेंस अगेंस्ट द ground of insanity. Okay, this is very important. You need to remember this rule. Therefore, according to McNaughton rule, to plead not to be guilty, the accused has to prove that he was suffering from mental illness and the mental illness was of a such a degree that he was unable to understand the nature or quality of his act, or was unable to understand that he was doing was wrong. So, यहां पे अगर McNaughton's rule के according अगर किसी को guilty जो है वो feel नहीं होना है, plead नहीं होना है, not to be guilty, then उनको उसको क्या prove करना पड़ेगा? Two things he need to prove. He was suffering from mental illness or he was not able to understand the nature and quality of the act or unable to understand that what he was doing was wrong. Still, there were some criticism on McNaughton's rule that it is argued that for deciding the insanity of a person, only cognitive factors or reasons are taken into consideration, but other factors also influence the conduct and behavior of a person, such as emotional factors, ability of individual to control the impulse, and loss of self-control. So these are some of the criticism what was passed against McNaughton's rule. It was held that the McNaughton rule is old and obsolete and needs correction. Subsequent to McNaughton's rule, new rules were provided and debated, such as Curran's rule, Durham's rule, and ALI test, etc. A brief account is presented regarding this rule. So here are some of the rules which has come recently, that the name is Curran's rule, Durham's rule, and ALI test. And here all the tests are given in this slide. So Durham's rule, 1954, an accused person is not criminally responsible for if their unlawful act, if it is the product of mental disease or mental defect. So yahan pe bhi same kaha gaya hai ki wo criminally responsible nahi hai agar wo jo unlawful act hai, it is a product of mental disease or mental defect. The next is Curran's rule, 1964. These rules state that an accused person is not criminally responsible if at the time of committing the act, he could not regulate his conduct to the requirements of the law due to mental disease or defect. यहाँ पे भी ये updated है, but ऐसा ही बाल माना गया है कि at the time of committing act, जब वो act करता है, he could not regulate his conduct to the requirements of the law due to mental disease or mental defect or illness. American Law Institute test, 1917, a person is not responsible for criminal conduct if, as a result of mental disease or defect, he lacked adequate capacity either to appreciate the wrongfulness of his conduct. Unko pata nahi hai. He has lacked एडिक्वेट कैपेसिटी, उनके पास वो कैपेसिटी नहीं है कि वो जो कर रहा है, वो जो क्रिमिनल एक्ट कर रहा है उसकी रॉन्गफुलनेस के बारे में, उसकी रॉन्गफुलनेस वो एप्रिसिएट कर सके, और टू कंफर्म हिज कंडक्ट टू द रिक्वायरमेंट्स ऑफ द लॉ एट द टाइम ऑफ सच कंडक्ट, और टू कंफर्म हिज कंडक्ट टू द रिक्वायरमेंट्स, और उनकी जो कंडक्ट है वो कंडक्ट कैसी होनी चाहिए अकॉर्डिंग टू लॉ, वो भी उनको पता नहीं चलता है जब वो काम करता है एट द टाइम ऑफ सच कंडक्ट, राइट, दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग इज कॉन्ट्रेरी टू लॉ, वो जो कर रहा है वो लॉ के विरुद्ध है, ऐसा उनको पता नहीं चलता है, वो कंडक्ट नहीं कर पाता है. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. यू कैन सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल, यू कैन क्लिक बेल आइकॉन एंड शेयर दिस वीडियो अमंगस्ट योर फ्रेंड्स. थैंक यू.